Lux presents Hollywood. Lever Brothers Company, the makers of Lux Flakes, bring you the Lux Radio Theatre. Our play, Alexander's Ragtime Band. Our stars, Tyrone Power, Dinah Shore, Dick Haymes, Margaret Whiting, and who could better set the stage than Al Jolson?
Come on in here. Come on in here. Alexander's Ragtime Band. Come on in here. Come on in here. It's the best band in the land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you want to go to war. That's just the business band. What am? Oh, honey lamb. Come on along. Come on along. Let me take you by the hand. Up to the man. You know the man. Who's the leader of the band. And if you care to hear the Swanee River played in ragtime. Come on in here. Come on in here. Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Ladies and gentlemen, the producer of the Lux Radio Theater, William Keeley.
Greetings from Hollywood, ladies and gentlemen. In the early days of Tin Pan Alley, a young man battling with poverty sat down to write the song you've just heard, Alexander's Ragtime Band. It not only made the name of Irving Berlin famous, but it helped establish ragtime as a permanent, exciting idiom in music. And tonight we bring you the heartwarming and romantic story of that song from 20th Century Fox's great hit of the same name, which is currently playing in theaters throughout the country. From the original screen cast, we have Tyrone Power. And as our special stars, Al Jolson, Dick Haymes, Dinah Shore, and Margaret Whiting. While we were rehearsing for tonight's play, I couldn't help thinking that the history of Alexander's Ragtime Band and that of Lux Flakes had a lot in common. Both swept the country on a growing wave of popularity until each became a household word throughout America. Not only that, but they maintained their popularity year after year. Today, the housewife who sings as she washes the dishes is probably singing Alexander's Ragtime Band and using Lux Flakes. It's time for our first act, starring Al Jolson as himself, Dinah Shore as Stella, Dick Haymes as Charlie Dwyer, Margaret Whiting as Jerry, and Tyrone Power as Alexander. San Francisco, 1915. It's standing room only in the Majestic Theater. But the celebrated entertainer, Al Jolson, has just come to town with another of his sensational shows.
Lazy. I want to be lazy. I want to lay out in the sun with no work to be done under that awning they call the sky, stretching and yawning and watch the world go drifting by. I want to peep through the deep tangled wildwood, counting sheep like I sleep as a child would, with a great big valise full of books to read where it's peaceful, while I'm killing time being lazy. While I'm killing time being lazy.
Great show, Al. That curtain sure brought the house down.
Thanks, Joe.
Say, Al, Georgie wants to know, should he leave that bid in for Helen? He worked in swell tonight.
Sure, give the kid a break. Any messages, Bert?
No, you're not forgetting the mayor's supper party.
Anything else?
Oh, yes, Roger Grant called.
Again? Well, he's persistent, if nothing else.
Oh, I think he's got a pretty good band.
So do I. That's why I've been trying to get him a job. Well, I guess Kramer doesn't like good music, huh?
Oh, no. Grant stopped by to thank you.
He's got the job? Swell.
Well, not quite. But Kramer's agreed to a tryout tomorrow night.
I hadn't come to Frisco to find jobs for band leaders. But Grant's father had been a friend of mine, and, well, you know how it is. Kramer's Cafe wasn't the best place in town, but he sure served a wonderful cheese blintz. Anyway, young Grant brought his band there the next night. The same night that Stella Kirby came looking for a job.
What do you want?
Oh, they tell me you're going in for music. Here I am.
Singer, huh?
That's right and good. I've been up at Lefty's for 3 months.
Why not now?
Well, Lefty got fresh and I quit. Oh, I know I'll be safe in a nice, refined place like this.
Sense of humor, huh? And what else?
What else? This, a brand new song that's dynamite.
Alexander's Ragtime Band.
I'll sing it for you right now.
Now, relax, girlie, relax. I'll tell you when.
Thanks, Mr. Kramer.
Stella Kirby.
Well, for crying out loud. Snapper, what are you doing here?
Well, still banging the drums, Stella. But this time for a very high-class guy named Roger Grant. And you?
Still banging out ballads, Snapper, if Kramer hires me.
Hey, Charlie, meet Stella Kirby.
Hi.
Oh, this is Charlie Dwyer, Stella, the best piano player in Frisco.
Hello, Miss Kirby.
Say, you fellas play here?
We're trying to get a job. Going to play for Kramer right now.
I'm singing for him later. I'll probably meet you out on the sidewalk, Mr. Dwyer.
All right, Charlie. Snapper, let's get going.
Uh-huh.
Oh, excuse me.
Stella Kirby, Roger Grant.
Hi.
How do you do? Charlie, I want the piano soft, understand? You too, Snapper. Soft and dreamy.
Right.
Oh, you'll excuse us, Miss Kirby.
Oh, sure. Sure.
Nice girl, Snapper.
Oh, boy.
Hey, keep your mind on business.
All right, you fellas, start playing. You better be good, see? I don't care about Jolson did send you.
Well, come on, Charlie. The music. The music. Where is it?
The music.
Well?
Raj, it's gone.
Are you crazy? You had the music. I saw it.
The streetcar. I must have left it on the streetcar.
The guy's gonna play or not?
Oh, yes, Mr. Kramer. Right away.
Hey, Raj, look, here's some music right here on the chair.
What is it? Let me see.
Alexander's Ragtime Band. What's that?
I don't know. Just pass out the parts.
Hey, what is this?
Here you are, fellas. No time to rehearse, but...
Yeah, just okay. Do your best, boys.
Oh, right, Larry.
Okay, then. Let's go.
Hey, what kind of rhythm is this?
I don't know. It's crazy.
Oh, Kramer will murder us for this.
Hey, what goes on here? That's my music.
Please, please, Miss Kirby, we're trying to...
That's my number. Where'd you find it?
Please. Hey, fellas, I've got it. Just loosen up a little bit. Hit it. Come on now.
Now listen, you crook. That's my song, and I'm going to sing it, see? Oh, my honey, oh, my honey, better hurry and let's meander. Ain't you going to the leader man, ragged meter man? Oh, my honey, let me take you to Alexander's grandstand brass band. Ain't you coming along? Come on in here, come on in here, Alexander's ragtime band. Come on in here, come on in here, it's the best band in the land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you want to go to war. That's just the bestest band what am. Oh, my honeyland, come on along, come on along. Let me take you by the hand to the man. To the man who's the leader of the band. And if you want to hear the Swanee River play it in ragtime, come on in here, come on in here, Alexander's Ragtime Band. All right, Fancy Pants. dance. What's the idea of swiping my music?
I'm sorry, Miss Kirby, but we...
Hey, that was dynamite. You got the job, sister, and you too, maestro.
Look, I came here to get a job for myself, not these amateurs. It was my music that put them over.
Just because you can shout notes, you know everything about music.
It's all of you or nothing. Hey, Pinky, beer in the house. For Alexander, this ragtime band.
My name's Grant.
It's Alexander, see? From now on.
Your name's Mud as far as I'm concerned, and if you think I'm going to work with you...
Who said I'd have you?
Give me my music.
Now, wait a second. Please, Miss Kirby, let's figure this out.
I got it figured out, Mr. Dwyer. I don't want anything to do with this.
Always a pleasure to meet a lady. Good night, Miss Kirby.
You stuck up.
Now, wait. Roz was just shooting off his mouth. That's all, Miss Kirby. We all need a job.
Well, I don't. Not that bad, I don't.
Now, just give me 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Now, let's sit down over here and talk this thing over calmly.
Well, I started something when I sent Roger Grant for a tryout at Kramer's. Except now, he wasn't Roger Grant anymore. He was Alexander, and he and the Ragtime Band and Stella Kirby, well, they really began to go places. 6 months later, they were opening at the famous Cliff House, but it was still cat and dog between Stella and Alex.
I didn't come to your dressing room to argue, Stella.
Then what do you want?
Just to see how you look. We're at the Cliff House now. This happens to be a big night for us, and... Oh, no.
Well?
Oh, that dress.
This dress cost me my last dime.
And you got stuck. All those feathers. It's a shame to hide such a beautiful throat under feathers. So let's just pull them off.
Hey, listen!
And those phony flowers. Why gild the lily, Miss Kirby?
Give me those flowers.
I'm afraid that jewelry will have to come off, too.
You two-by-four snob. I'll wear what I like, and if
I'm trying to build a band that has class.
Go build yourself a band, but nobody's telling me what I wear. Understand? Nobody.
Hey, Alex, that manager's out there throwing a fit. We better get going.
I'm not singing.
Stella!
Well, let her do what she wants. I don't want a girl with a band anyway.
Oh, here we go again.
Why did I ever let you talk me into this, Charlie?
Oh, but Stella, he didn't mean anything. It's opening night. He's excited, that's all.
Look. Look what he did to my feathers.
Oh, what's a few feathers? Come on, you've got to sing now.
I'll see him dead first.
All right, then. Don't sing for Alex. Sing for me. What do you say, Stella? Please.
Oh, Charlie.
Now you're talking, honey. Come on.
All right. Why let you take advantage of my good nature?
There you are. See how easy it is.
Yeah. Something tells me I'm sticking my head right into a noose.
Well, they hit Frisco like another earthquake. 20 weeks later, they were still in the Cliff House, the biggest draw in town. One afternoon in the rehearsal room...
Hello, Stella. Rehearsal's not till 4 o'clock.
Oh, just thought I'd get over a little early, Charlie.
Hey, another new outfit, huh?
Charlie, it isn't too loud, is it?
I think it's great. You know, you've changed, Stella. Changed a lot.
Changed? Just because I buy quieter clothes and let my hair go natural?
Oh, that's part of it, I guess.
You mean I'm getting refined? Agreeable? Well, you're wrong. Just trying to save myself a lot of arguments with Alex, that's all.
Oh, sure, sure.
Yeah. What's that you're playing?
Just a little hit tune I've been working on.
You mean you wrote it? You?
Mm-hmm. Like it?
How does the rest of it go?
Well, suppose I go back to the beginning.
Now it can be told, told in all its glory. Now that we have met, the world may know the sentimental story. The greatest romance they ever knew is waiting to unfold. Now it can be told as an inspiration. Every other tale of boy meets girl is just an imitation. the great love story has never been told before. But now it can be told.
Charlie, it's great. Marvelous.
Hey, take it easy.
No, not on the level. That, gee.
I wrote it for you, Stella. If it's any good, that's why.
Thank you, Charlie. I'd love to sing it.
Sing it? Oh, sure. Sure, I'll speak to Alex. Maybe we can work it into the program tonight.
Oh, Charlie.
Yeah, Alex.
Take over, will you, Charlie? I'm going outside for a minute. Stella.
Alex.
I really think Charlie's got a hit on his hands.
Alex, what are you doing here on the terrace?
Well, it's Charlie's tune, and I thought he ought to conduct his own song. Stella, the way you sang it before, I never knew you could sing it like that.
Didn't you?
Stella, you didn't sing that song for somebody, did you? I mean, somebody in particular?
Maybe.
That's what I thought. I'm afraid to ask who.
You don't have to be. You probably know you're conceited enough.
Oh, Stella. Stella.
Imagine you and me like this. What happened, Alex?
I guess the roof just fell in on us.
The minute I started to sing that song, Alex, do you suppose we've been in love with each other all the time?
Me? In love with a girl who wears feathers? Yeah. Yeah, feathers and everything.
Oh, Alex, this is the real thing, isn't it?
The realest thing that's ever happened, Stella.
Well, that's what happens when you write a song. Take Charlie Dwyer now. He pours out his heart in a song for Stella, and she takes it out and pours her heart out to another fella. Well, they just about set a date for the wedding when Charlie Dillingham, the New York producer, came to the coast. He happened to hear Stella sing, and an hour later...
Alex, Charlie, it's wonderful. He wants me to go to New York, Mr. Dillingham.
New York?
Yeah, he's going to make me a star, Alex. Oh, darling, everything you wanted for me.
Yes, but what about the band?
Well, he says he can't use the band now, but he'll find a place later.
Oh, and you're going?
Well, of course I'm going. Turn down the biggest break I'll ever get.
You might have talked to me about it first.
Well, we'll still be together. You can come on to New York. You'll get a job.
That'll be great.
But you've told me over and over I could make something of myself if I tried. And now, just because it's happened, you're angry.
Serves me right expecting anything from you.
Of all the selfish little tin-horn sports, you're jealous. Jealous because he wants me and not you.
Go on, go to New York.
Don't think I won't. And don't think you wouldn't do the same thing if you had the chance.
Alex, tell her you're wrong before it's too late.
No, I'm wrong and she's right.
Yes. You don't own Stella. She doesn't owe the band a thing. We're liable to be stuck here for the rest of our lives.
If that's the way you feel about it, what are you sticking around for? Why don't you clear out, too?
All right. Maybe that's a good idea.
Hiya, Charlie.
Excuse me, Snapper.
Sure. Well, Maestro, when does Alexander's Ragtime Band hit Broadway?
It doesn't. There isn't any Alexander's Ragtime Band.
In a moment, we'll continue with Act Two of Alexander's Ragtime Band, starring Dinah Shore, Dick Hames, Tyrone Power, Margaret Whiting, and Al Jolson. Libby, I hope you'll pardon my looking twice, but I wasn't sure the first time whether those were really stockings you're wearing. Nylons, huh?
Mm-hmm. Aren't they gorgeous?
Yes.
Oh, I've never had such sheer ones. And there's quite a story goes with them.
Well, let's have it.
Well, you know, one day when I was visiting at 20th Century Fox, I spent some time with Maureen O'Hara on the set of Homestretch.
Well, that suggests horses, but not stockings.
Well, there are scenes at 11 different tracks, and that gives Maureen an opportunity to wear some gorgeous clothes. 41 costume changes, in fact. and every one a dream in Technicolor.
And beautiful nylons to go with each costume?
Right. Well, while I was there, Maureen and Cornell Wilde were shooting a night scene for Homestretch near the studio swimming pool. Maureen stumbled on the gravel walk and skinned both knees.
Oh, too bad.
Well, of course, that meant a new pair of stockings because they were lovely one-thread shears. Well, I raved about them, but I said they just wouldn't be practical for me. And you know what?
What?
Well, the wardrobe man said, "Lady, if you take care of them right, they'll give you plenty of wear." And then he told me very seriously how the studio Lux's stockings, as well as other washables, to get longer wear from them.
That shouldn't surprise a Lux girl like you, Libby. Remember those stocking strain tests we talked about?
Mm-hmm.
They were made with many different kinds of stockings. Silk, rayon, nylon, and cotton. And they all showed similar results. Time after time, the Lux stockings outlasted by a wide margin those washed with a strong soap.
Oh, but you haven't heard the whole story yet, Mr. Kennedy. The next day, Miss O'Hara sent me a lovely gift. 6 pairs of the very same kind of nylon she wore in the picture. And you can be sure they'll get Lux care.
Then they should give you excellent wear, Libby. You know, those strain tests proved that Lux stockings lasted twice as long. That's like getting the wear of an extra pair from every pair of your new stockings. No wonder girls all over the country make Lux their rule for stocking care. It pays. Lux stockings last longer. We return you now to William Keeley.
Act 2 of Alexander's Ragtime Band, starring Dick Hames as Charlie, Tyrone Power as Alexander, Margaret Whiting as Jerry, Al Jolson as himself, and Dinah Shore as Stella.
A lot happened in the next couple of years, including the First World War. The day after he got back from France, Alex was standing on Broadway in front of the Globe Theater. There was a playbill in the lobby. Charles Dillingham presents Stella Kirby in Come One, Come All, opening next week.
Who? Who did you say wanted to see me, Harry?
He was waiting right here at the stage door, Miss Kirby, till rehearsal was over. And he
Hello, said... Stella.
Alex! Alex! Where in the world? Oh, it's good to see you.
I saw your name out front, just thought I'd drop in.
When'd you get back?
Yesterday.
You're all right?
Oh, sure, not a scratch.
Well, then, why are you...
Oh, you mean the cane? Well, it's just a little fad I picked up on the other side.
Alex, I tried to see you before you left.
You did?
Yeah, when you were doing that show for the Army, that last night. When I went backstage, you'd gone.
It's too bad we didn't get together, Stella. I wanted to tell you how sorry I was for everything. Can you forgive me?
Of course.
I've never stopped loving you, Stella.
Alex.
Oh, you don't know what it's been like. Wanting you every second. You've never been out of my mind.
Alex, you don't know?
Know what?
Charlie and I, we've been married for more than a year.
No, I didn't know.
Stella, Mr. Dillingham says we... Alex!
Hello, Charlie.
You just got back.
That's right.
Oh, I'm sorry I wasn't with you over there. I never got further than Hoboken.
I see you're doing the songs for Stella's new show. Congratulations.
Oh, thanks. But blame it on Stella. She cracked the whip.
Well, it's been great seeing you.
Well, can't we have lunch? You don't have to rush right out.
Sorry, a couple of fellas are waiting for me. Goodbye, Stella.
Goodbye, Alex.
Charlie.
So long. Look, he's limping. He's changed, hasn't he, Stella?
Yes, and in some ways. But still too proud even to say he'd been wounded.
Here's the setup. We round up some of the boys, maybe Davy, maybe Ed, if we can find them, you and me, and we put Alexander's Ragtime Band right back on the map. What do you say?
Have another drink, Snapper.
No, listen, will you? Jerry here has swell pipes, haven't you, Jerry?
Sure, the agents are fighting over who gets me. Each one wants to give me up to the other guy.
No, cut it out, will you? Show him, Jerry, just let him hear you sing something.
Now? Maybe he's got fussy neighbors.
Mm. Go ahead, Jerry. Sing for me.
All right, I will. Bluebirds singing a song,
nothing but bluebirds all day long. Never saw the sun shining so bright. I never saw things going so right. Noticing the day.
Great, Jerry. Swell.
Oh, thanks.
There, you see what I mean, Alex? Why, we can be back in the running bigger than ever.
What's your hurry?
Well, we gotta eat, don't we?
Why?
Say, are you nuts?
Sure. Do you mind, Jerry?
Oh, no, I'm a little cracked myself.
You see, Jerry understands. We heroes have to have a little time to adjust ourselves.
Alex, look, I need a job. So does Jerry. We can't wait around for the mood to hit you.
Oh, let him alone, Snapper. He doesn't want to talk business.
Business? What's that?
Oh, the thing you do to take your mind off drinking.
Jerry, you're a very understanding girl. I wish I was raring to go, but unfortunately I'm not.
Oh, forget it. It's all the same to me.
I'm just out of step, I guess.
You'll catch up.
Sure. But when?
Like Snapper says, when the mood hits.
I guess it was about a month later that I bumped into Stella and Charlie on Madison Avenue. Stella didn't look too well. Maybe it was the strain of her new show. Maybe it was that meeting she'd had with Alex. Anyway, it was good seeing him again.
But what are you doing in New York, Al? I thought you were on the road.
Just got back, Charlie. Say, I caught your show, Stella. Right up on top, aren't you? And those tunes of yours, Charlie. Oh, boy, they're great.
Oh, Al, you're a sweetheart. We'll never forget you had a hand in all of it. Way back in the beginning.
Funny, isn't it? You and Charlie on Broadway and Alex down at Greenwich Village.
Alex? In the village?
That's right. In my restaurant.
Your restaurant?
Look, Charlie, when a man loves cheese blintzes as much as I do, he'd even buy a restaurant just to make sure to be around when he wants them.
What place is it, Al?
What place is it? Scarby's. Alex and Snapper put the band together, and they're starting to pack them in again. Why don't you kids come down?
Thanks, Al. We will. Good meeting Al tonight, wasn't it, Stella?
Hmm? Oh, yeah.
Funny about Alex. I thought he'd gone back to Frisco.
So did I.
What do you say we drop in on him sometime? Just for old time's sake.
Oh, those old times are over, Charlie. It never works trying to rake them up again.
Sometimes it does. Oh, if you're not too tired, I've got a new number. Like to hear it?
Of course, dear.
Sure you're up to it. It's sort of on the sentimental side.
Aren't you always? Come on now, let me hear it.
I lost the sunshine and roses. I lost the heavens of blue. I lost the beautiful rain. I lost the morning dew. I lost the angel who gave me summer the whole winter through. I lost the gladness that turned into sadness when I lost you.
Charlie, it's just beautiful.
To you.
Like all the rest of them, Stella. Except this one's sort of a... well... sort of a swan song.
Charlie.
I've been doing a lot of thinking lately, Stella. Making up a lot of speeches about life and marriage. Very profound stuff. But it all seems very silly now that we're...
Charlie, what is it?
Well, here goes. What do you say we call this marriage off?
Charlie.
Stella. Stella, you're still in love with Alex, aren't you?
I thought I was all over it, Charlie, but I guess you just can't turn those things on and off.
That's what I'm getting at. Well, I'm a lucky guy to have had you as long as I had. I'm grateful for every minute of it. But, Stella, I want you to be happy.
Oh, Charlie. Charlie, you're so wonderful.
Oh, sure. Sure. Well, I should have known it all along, Stella. Now, you go on and get the divorce, and then you and Alex can make a life for yourselves. A real life.
Oh, Charlie, what can I say?
Not a word. People talk too much anyhow.
Stella. Well, welcome to Scarvey's.
Hello, Al.
Did you come to see Alex?
Yes, I did.
He'll be through in a minute. Then we're having our own private party.
Party?
Sure, come on over here. They've got a table all set for us.
Oh, wait now, Al. I just want to see Alex. I don't want to barge
hey,
in on a party.
Is that Stella Kirby?
Hello, Snapper.
Oh, Stella, you look terrific. And where's Charlie? I haven't seen him in years.
He's out of town.
Oh. Well, he's the only one of the old gang not here. Hey, Alex, look, Stella Kirby.
Hello, Stella.
Hello, Alex.
Just in time for the celebration. Oh, this is Jerry Allen, Mrs. Dwyer.
How do you do?
How do you do?
How's Charlie?
Fine, thanks. I didn't mean to break in on you here.
Oh, I'm glad you did. We're leaving tonight.
That's right. We're on our way to Europe, Stella. Well, how do you like it?
Europe?
Yeah, they needed a band in a hurry, and we were lucky.
Lucky nothing. They've got the best band in New York. I wish I had them in my show. And you ought to hear Jerry sing.
I guess I've taken your place, Miss Kirby. Well, I tried to, anyway.
Oh, Jerry's great. One of the best.
Oh, say, Alec. There are a couple of friends of mine over there who want to meet you. Come on, son. Give them a break, will you?
Okay. Excuse me, Stella.
Don't be long, Alex.
I'm sorry I missed hearing you sing, Jerry. How long have you been with the band?
Well, ever since it started again.
Oh, then you must have met Alex soon after he came back from the war.
Yes. He was still in sort of a daze from it. I stepped in and, well, I tried to help him snap out of it.
That was very fortunate for him.
For me, too. You see, Alex and I are engaged.
Oh. Oh, I'm very happy for you.
Well, thanks.
All right, boys, let's go to work. Come on, Jerry.
Already? Oh, Miss Kirby, would you sing a number? Why don't you?
Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather not...
Oh, please. They'd love it, I know.
Why not, Stella? A sort of goodbye gesture.
Just for luck. I'll go make an announcement.
Well, Stella?
I guess I won't have a chance to say goodbye later. I'll say it now, Alex.
Goodbye.
Good luck to you over there.
Good luck to you, Stella.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we've a wonderful surprise for you. There's a great celebrity with us tonight, and she's agreed to sing a number for us. May I present Miss Stella Kirby.
Thank you, Jerry. Remember the night you said I love you. Remember you vowed by all the stars above you. Remember, we found a lonely spot, and after I learned to care a lot, you promised that you'd forget me not.
But you forgot to remember.
So long, Alex.
Bye, Al. Bye, Stella.
Well, there they go, Stella.
Goodbye, Alex. Goodbye, darling.
We pause now for station identification. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.
In a moment, we'll return with Act Three of Alexander's Ragtime Band, starring Tyrone Power, Margaret Whiting, Al Jolson, Dinah Shore, and Dick Hames. You've seen the face of our guest tonight on many a magazine cover. And now, 20th Century Fox has signed blonde, blue-eyed Marion Marshall to a long-term screen contract. What's your ambition, Marion?
To become a really fine actress, Mr. Keeley.
Well, you can pick up a good many tips on acting technique at 20th Century Fox.
Oh, I have. I just haunted the set of the late George Apley when Ronald Coleman and Peggy Cummins were making the picture. Peggy's a darling. She even invited me to her dressing room.
Did you see her collection of Dresden figurines?
Yes, I loved them.
Do you have a hobby, Marion?
My pet extravagance, Mr. Keeley, is pretty lingerie. Though, unfortunately, my budget won't call for much.
Well, John Kennedy might have some advice for you there. How about it, John?
Well, there's a very simple way, Miss Marshall, to add to your collection. You could buy yourself three times as many pretty undies without spending a cent more.
Why, that sounds wonderful. How?
By always using Lux. You see, it's been proved by actual tests that Lux Care keeps slips and nighties lovely three times as long as those washed the wrong way. Well, if undies stay lovely three times as long, obviously they don't have to be replaced nearly so often. So instead of spending money to replace drab, faded undies, you can buy more new ones. You can have three times as many.
I see what you mean, Mr. Kennedy. You know, that reminds me of a pretty lingerie set Miss Cummings showed me. Shell pink satin with deeper applique. Every stitch handmade.
That doesn't sound like that 1912 atmosphere of the late George Apley.
Oh, she doesn't wear it in the picture. A fan sent it to her from Ireland. It's really beautiful. And she says it'll stay that way a long time because nothing but Lux ever touches her lingerie.
Clever girl. She's thrifty, too, because with gentle Lux care, lingerie stays lovely a long, long time. In fact, three times as long. That's a good idea for girls everywhere to remember. Thank you for coming tonight, Miss Marion Marshall, and good luck. Back now to your producer, William Keeley.
Act Three of Alexander's Ragtime Band, starring Dinah Shore as Stella, Al Jolson as himself, Margaret Whiting as Jerry, Dick Hames as Charlie, and Tyrone Power as Alexander.
Her marriage ended, and with Alex in Europe, Stella's world sort of fell to pieces. She suddenly left for a show on Broadway and just, well, just disappeared. I'd get a letter now and then from Alex. His band and Jerry's voice were the toast of London.
Hey,
Thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the management is very happy to present those great American favorites, Alexander's Ragtime Band and Miss Jerry Allen.
Heaven, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to climb a mountain and to reach the highest peak, but it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to go out fishing in a river or a creek, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Dance with me, I want my arm about you, the charm about you will carry me through to heaven. I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
I don't mind walking, Alex. They say that London fog makes your cheeks rosy. I'm afraid it makes you wet, too.
Oh, sorry, Jerry. We'll get a cab.
Oh, come on. I was just kidding. I wanted to see if you still remembered how to talk.
I guess I'm not very good company these days.
What's on your mind, Alex?
Oh, I was just thinking about...
That's strange. So was I.
You were what?
Wondering about Stella Kirby.
So you're a mind reader.
Well, maybe when it comes to you and Stella.
Well, it wasn't her I was thinking about so much as all the things that have happened.
And she was just part of them?
Yeah. Yeah, part of things that seemed so important at the time, and now I can talk about them and they don't matter at all.
Just closed accounts. And you know, it's funny. Person falls in love head over heels. This is it, you say. There'll never be anyone else. There couldn't be. And then something happens and it's all over. You bounce right out of it like a rubber ball.
So what are we waiting for? You and I. Don't you think it's time we got married?
Oh, don't get on that subject again.
Well, why not? A couple of months ago it was all set. Let's take the plunge now. Tonight, hmm?
I hadn't finished what I was going to say, Alec. I wonder if I'll be able to get over you as easily as you've been able to get over Stella. To forget you as you've forgotten her.
Jerry,
Oh, you don't really want to marry me, Alex. It's that bachelor tax you're trying to avoid.
Don't you think we'd get along?
Well, of course we would.
Then why not?
Because you aren't in love with me. I used to think you were, but I was wrong.
You mean an awful lot to me, Jerry.
Thanks, but that's not enough to marry on. I'm not complaining, Alex, and I'm not asking for a thing. You just remember that.
You think too straight for me, Jerry. But you're a swell person.
I should have my head examined. Come on, this fog is leaking through my shoes.
Alex and Jerry were back in New York that fall. Starred in the Tropics room at the Drake Hotel. They'd been there a couple of weeks when...
Charlie Dwyer, well, sit down. How are you?
Fine, Alex. And you?
Swell. How have you been doing?
Oh, so-so. What's all this about a concert at Carnegie Hall?
it's not settled yet.
Mm-hmm.
But I have an idea that people might go for this popular music. Well, how's Stella?
I don't know.
What?
I haven't heard from her, Alex. She disappeared right after the divorce.
Divorce? You and Stella? Well, I thought you two were leading a quiet life someplace, raising a family.
Not Stella. Things got a little tough for me, and she walked out.
Now, wait a minute. Stella wouldn't walk out on anybody.
She did on me.
Stella's the swellest girl I ever knew, Charlie. If she walked out on you, it's because she had a good reason.
So you're still in love with her.
Well, what about it?
That's all I wanted to know. Because she's still in love with you.
What?
She didn't walk out, Alex. We busted up, that's all.
Well, Charlie, I've got to find her.
I've been trying for months myself. Somebody saw her singing in a dive. By the time I got there, she'd gone. She's changed her name, Alex. Dropped right out of the picture.
Hello, Stella.
Hello, Al. I saw you when you came in. What are you doing in a joint like this?
That's what I want to ask you, Stella Kirby. Stella Kirby's singing here.
No, Al, it's Lily Leonard now. I changed my name to fit the personality.
Seen Alex?
Nope.
You're going to the concert tonight, aren't you?
I don't think so.
This is a pretty big night for him. He'd kind of like to know you were sitting out there. And so would I.
You don't need me, Al. Neither does Alex.
He's been looking high and low for you, that's all.
He has?
Sure. Why don't you go and see him?
No. Let him keep thinking of me the way I was.
You're crazy, Stella. You're coming with me to that concert.
No, thanks. I finish up here tonight, and I'm catching a train at 11.
Look, I've got to make a phone call. I'll be right back.
To Alex?
Alex, no, certainly not.
Joe.
What's the matter, Leo?
Joe, when that man comes back, tell him I couldn't wait.
Okay.
Plenty of gas in the camp, lady. Where do you want to go now?
Well, I still got an hour to kill before my train leaves. Just drive around, huh?
Okay. Like some music? Yeah, not bad, eh? Hey. Boy, that guy sure got it.
Where's that coming from?
Carnegie Hall. Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Please.
Oh, what's the matter, lady? You want us to turn it on?
No. Leave it on.
Yeah, you know, we ought to stop so we can appreciate it. That's Carnegie Hall, lady, right there.
I didn't ask you to go to Carnegie Hall.
Oh, we might just as well be standing still as cruising around. Say, you know, too bad you can't be in there.
The house is sold out.
Oh, sure. But you could sneak in the stage entrance, though. I do that a lot.
Turn the radio off. I've heard all I want.
Yeah, but Al Jolson's going to sing. You can't miss him. Oh, and then they're sure to play Alexander's Ragtime Band.
I don't want to hear it. Turn it off.
Huh. Well, why don't you want to hear it?
Because I can't, that's all.
Sure, Miss Kirby.
How did you know my name?
Oh, I heard you sing many a time.
And you remembered me.
Sure. You were great. You know, you ought to be in there, Miss Kirby. Go on, why don't you? Go ahead.
Most beloved performers of all time, my friend Al Jolson.
A pretty girl is like a melody that haunts you night and day, just like a strain of a haunting refrain. She'll start upon a marathon and run around your brain. You can't escape. She's in your memory by morning, night, and noon. She will leave you and then come back again. A pretty girl is just like a pretty tune. just like a pretty tune.
Thanks, Al. Thanks. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play Alexander's Ragtime Band for two reasons. First, because I consider it the best of all swing songs. And second, because this particular song means more to me than any other piece of music. I'd like to play it not only for you and for the people with whom you may associate it, but also for the people and especially for the one person with whom I associate it.
Sorry, miss. No one's allowed backstage. You'll have to... Miss Kirby! Come right in, Miss Kirby. You can see fine from the wings here.
Thank you.
Stella.
Hello, Al.
Look out there, Stella. He sees you. He wants you on the stage.
Oh, no, I can't.
Go ahead. Get out there. This is your number, Stella.
Stella.
Oh, no, I...
Go on, I tell you. That's the girl.
Come on, Stella. Sing.
Oh, Al.
Sing, darling. Sing.
Come along, let me take you by the hand to the man who's the leader of the band. And if you want to hear that Swanee River play, come on in here, Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Our stars will be back for their curtain calls in a moment. I read an amazing thing the other day. Last year, American women spent over $22 million on nail polish and other manicure preparations. They say 75% of the women in this country use nail polish. Well, now it seems from that as if women cared a lot about the way their hands look. And yet, when you see how many women have dishpan hands, well, you wonder why they don't do something about it. They could get rid of those red, rough hands for just about 1 cent a day, simply by changing from strong soaps to Lux for dishes. Isn't that easy? Look at your own hands. Are you really proud of them? Suppose you were having your husband's boss to dinner or were invited to join a new bridge club. Would you be just a little embarrassed about your hands? No, you don't need any beauty treatments to get those hands of yours back in shape. Just change from those strong soaps you've been using to gentle Lux flakes. Scores of women have proved by actual scientific tests that this is an idea which really works. You'll begin to notice a difference in just a few days, and before long, your hands will be as soft and smooth as they used to be. Another thing you'll like about Lux Flakes, they're so thrifty. Ounce for ounce, Lux washes up to twice as many dishes as any of 10 other leading soaps tested. Try it tomorrow. Here's Mr. Keeley at the microphone.
There's a 5-star closing to our play tonight as we bring them back in person for a curtain call. Al Jolson, Tyrone Power, Dinah Shaw, Dick Hames, and Margaret Whiting. You know, it's not often we're able to present 5 top stars like yourselves in one night.
Well, include yourself in, Bill, and make it 6.
Say, you know, Bill, there's somebody else who ought to take a bow tonight.
Who's that, Dinah?
I think I agree if you mean our orchestra conductor, Lou Silvers.
Right. And incidentally, Lou wrote one of your biggest hit tunes, didn't he, Al?
Yes. And there's no time any better than the present for me to get a plug in. Though April showers may come your way, they bring the flowers that bloom in May. Go ahead, Dick.
All right. You know... You know, April Showers is one of the top 4 tunes in the country now, Al.
Oh, yes.
I remember when Lou Silvers here conducted an orchestra for you, Al.
Yes, a small orchestra.
of some 116 pieces.
Small orchestra of 116 pieces?
Oh, wait till I pull this guy. Crosby will die. You say that again, Dinah.
Small orchestra of 116 pieces?
Sure, when you put all the pieces together, all you had was 8 instruments.
Speaking of music, Al, Dick's played in a band as well as sung.
Richard?
Is that right, Dick? What instruments did you play?
Well, I was sort of a one-man band. Played the harmonica with my mouth, beat the drums with one foot, and pumped an organ with the other foot.
What did you do with your hands?
Come over my ears!
How about you, Tyrone? Have you ever done anything in the field of music?
Well, I used to play the accordion, Bill.
Where?
Yeah, in a way that would bring tears to Xanax eyes.
You mean you were touched by your own playing?
No, but the accordion used to pinch my stomach.
Well, I want to know before we get too comical here, what's coming up on Lux next Monday night, Bill?
Well, in keeping with National Laugh Week, we've arranged to bring our audience next Monday night Paramount's hilarious new screen hit, Monsieur Beaucaire.
Monsieur Beaucaire.
Starring Joan Caulfield and Bob Hope. Yes, it's a streamlined, laugh-packed version of Booth Tarkington's immortal story in which Bob suffers plenty of close shaves as the barber who poses as a nobleman and gets into more hot water than his brush and razor.
Funny play, Bill.
Oh, nice line. Listen, and it ought to be funny with Bob Hope. Good night, Bill. Good night, Dinah.
Good night,
Dinah.
Good night to all of you.
Ames, good night, everybody.
Lever Brothers Company, the makers of Lux Flakes, join me in inviting you to be with us again next Monday evening when the Lux Radio Theatre presents Bob Hope and Joan Caulfield in Monsieur Beaucaire. This is William Keeley saying good night to you from Hollywood.
Tyrone Power appeared by arrangement with 20th Century Fox and will soon be seen in their Technicolor production, Captain from Castile. Dick Hames appeared through the courtesy of the Autolite Company and is currently being seen in the 20th Century Fox picture, Carnival in Costa Rica. Dinah Shore appeared through the courtesy of the Ford Motor Company. Margaret Whiting appeared by arrangement with the Pabst Blue Ribbon Program. Al Jolson appeared by arrangement with Columbia Pictures. Our music was directed by Louis Silvers. This program was broadcast to our service men and women overseas through the worldwide facilities of the United States Armed Forces Radio Service. And this is your announcer, John Milton Kennedy, reminding you to tune in again next Monday night to hear Monsieur Beaucaire with Bob Hope and Joan Caulfield.
When you bake and fry,
spry.
For your cake and pie,
spry.
Get your shortening by, rely on spry.
Want fried foods crisp, golden, better tasting? Try spry, the pure vegetable shortening for delicious, better tasting fried foods. So digestible, too, the spry way.
Rely on spry. S-P-R-Y.
Be sure to listen in next Monday night to the Lux Radio Theater presentation of Monsieur Beaucaire with Bob Hope and Joan Caulfield. And why not tune in to Joan Davis every Monday night over most of these stations? This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.